Ben Vuki for Boxing News TV. In association with EsNews, I'm here with the one and only Dillian Whyte. How are you doing today, Dillian?
I'm great. Just come up here to support my man, you know what I mean? You know, first start a fight, first box I manage, good friend of mine. So, you know, just trying to help him guide his career. When I was coming up, I never had no one helping me, so yeah.
So it's, your fighter is Richard Drake Poirier. He's fighting Sam Hyde for WBA Intercontinental or International Cruiserweight title. Tell us a bit about Richard, where he's come from, his background.
Tomorrow you guys will understand why we call him Richard Reactor Rear Kapoor. Tomorrow you guys will understand. The guy is tough, he's got power, he's tall, he's athletic, he's in great shape, and he's got a very good intelligent boxing brain, and he's a student of the game, you know. And he's done loads of camps with me, and he's on it, man. He's on it.
Got a very powerful punch from what I hear. Good puncher.
Yeah, you know, he's a good puncher and he can take a punch as well, you know. You know, we've had some wars.
Yeah, you spar with him a lot?
Yeah, I spar with him a lot and he's not scared as well, you know what I mean? You know, he's not someone, it doesn't matter about his weight, he comes in and he gets the work in, you know.
Okay, so we're here for the main event is Usyk Belyu. So yeah. Tell us your take on Usyk Belyu.
You know, it's a great fight, it's a hard fight for Tony, but never write Tony off. And he's a British fighter, so I'm going to support him. I think Tony Belyu stands a good puncher's chance, and if he lands it, if he does what he can do, I think he can win by KO.
Is that your prediction, or you think Usyk takes on points?
Second points, I believe, by knockout.
All right, okay, fantastic.
High chance he could get knockout as well, because he gets tagged and he does get hurt.
You think he's adamant that he won't return, but you think if he wins, he will?
If he wins, he'll return. Of course, he's not. If he wins, he'll return. You know, money in this game is a massive thing. If he wins, he'll return.
Who do you think we'd see him face then? Who would you like to see him face if he returns?
I don't know. You know, I just want him to make as much money as he can and live out his career, man. You know, he's been through the mills, so yeah.
What about Usyk? You want to see him up at heavyweight next?
You know what? Everyone's saying he's in a clean at heavyweight division. Heavyweight boxing is heavyweight boxing. Cruiserweight boxing is cruiserweight boxing. You know, so we'll see. There've been a few good cruiserweights moved up on campaign at heavyweight, but it's difficult.
Moving to your fight, 22nd of December, yeah. Chisora rematch. Yeah. It's okay. Gotta look good.
No, sorry.
Gotta get the shoes right. Okay. So yeah, you got your fight rematch with Chisora on 22nd of December. Already started preparations. How's things going?
Everything's good. I'm training good. I feel good. Still a bit of time to go. So now it's about pacing it instead of overcooking it. But I'm good. I'm ready to beat something up, man.
And so 22nd December, any of your guys going to be on the undercard?
Well, let's see how Richard does. We're trying to get Richard on. You know, there's a few people who are trying to get work in a few weeks. Well, let's jump out on a great undercard. If it's up to us, maybe that's all heavyweights and cruiserweights on the card. So let's see what happens.
Are you going to be back in Loughborough for training this time?
Yeah, I'm always in Loughborough training. That's where my camp is. I basically live there.
I tell you who wants to be on your undercard is Dave Allen. Said he'd love to be on your undercard.
Yeah, let him take your business tonight and we'll see, because I need Dave in for some sparring as well. So I'm going to speak to him. I'll let him get a fight out of the way. So yeah, win, lose, or draw, I'd like to get him on the card.
Fantastic. And just looking at a few other fights coming up, Wilder Fury. What's your take on Wilder Fury?
Great fight. You know, smart money says Wilder, but I'll listen to people. Don't write Tyson Fury off. Me and him have our differences, but he's a British fighter, so I'm going to support him. And hopefully he wins and bring the belt back, because unlike Wilder, Fury is willing to fight people and taking risks, as he's proven taking this fight. Wilder don't fight no one. Wilder is just trying to make easy money.
Mayweather talking about coming back. What's your take on that?
I don't care about that, man. Mayweather needs to chill, man.
You think he should stop now, yeah?
He needs to chill. He needs to chill.
Pacquiao Broner.
Great fight.
Who have you got in that one?
I don't know. Pacquiao would say, innit, but Pacquiao's aging and Broner is young. But Broner seems to be a bit all over the place and not consistent in an area, so let's see.
A lot of people saying we're going to see you get the stoppage in December. Are you going to be looking for that, or are you just going to take it as it comes?
I train hard. I train and stop every single opponent I fought. Every single opponent I fought, I stop them, I've hurt them, and I've dropped them.
Are we going to see you on April 13th in Wembley?
We'll see. One fight at a time. I'm not overlooking Derek. It's his last fight. He's in for revenge, isn't it? Going to train hard, so yeah.
Is that a big goal of yours, you know, getting back in there with Anthony, though?
It's the goal of mine, is getting back in there with heavyweight on the planet. We're here to take over. We're not here to take part.
You feel like Anthony's that fighter who You know, like you have those guys who have trilogies like Morales.
I'd fight him another 5-6 times in my career if I could. I'll fight him every 3 months if I could. You know.
Fantastic. It's been a pleasure speaking to Dillian. Hopefully catch up with you soon.
Cheers.
Okay. Thanks a lot, bro.